Sports Gaming Universe.
Hello and welcome to Sports Gaming Universe channel here on YouTube, and welcome back to my Chicago Cubs franchise series here in MLB 14, the show on the PS4. About ready to start a four-game set with the Arizona Diamondbacks, but first, we have a new special following one of our young up-and-coming players around town in Chicago. This is Justin Ruggiano, and a typical day before he arrives at the ballpark, driving around the suburbs a little bit, around Wrigleyville. And when he arrives near the stadium, there you go. There's Wrigley Field from the outside, just kind of taking it all in on the streets. A little bit incognito, just kind of chilling out. And eventually he'll make his way over to the ballpark, maybe just take a walk around a little bit as you see the Sears Tower there. And downtown out in the distance, but you see some fans hanging around the stadium before the game starts, and he'll make his way past a statue out front as well. So Justin Ruggiano about ready to enter the ballpark and get ready today here. He'll come back through the player's entrance. So not a whole lot going on with Ruggiano today before the game, but we'll follow him around town from time to time as we get a chance. So I'd like to thank Watch Dogs for the footage right there and being in Chicago. It fits right in with this series. Get a little bit of a look at the city, the Windy City, once in a while, leading into our ball game. So now it is time to play ball against the Arizona Diamondbacks. A nice 13-8 start for them. The Cubs 8-9, trying to get at 500 today. Sending Edwin Jackson to the mound, and he gets a strikeout to get himself out of the first inning there. And no harm will be done as the Cubs will come up and hit in the bottom of the first. They will be going against Hudson today. 3-2 count, two outs, and Rizzo has the bat on his shoulders, and that's not going to help him because that's strike three. Diamondbacks are out of the first as well. Here's a Gregorius ground out to third base, and Edwin Jackson is through the second. Both pitchers starting strong, or at least getting out of innings when they've got runners on. So we go to the bottom of the second, 3-1 count, two outs, and this is going to be backup catcher Baker getting the start today. He's going to ground out, and that's another easy inning for the Diamondbacks. So we're trading zeros into the third, and this is the pitcher Hudson at the plate, works a 3-2 count, and he hits this ball a long way. It's going to be off the ivy as Lake couldn't catch it. It's a double for Hudson, helping his own cause. Later on in the inning, it's second and third, still nobody out, and Prado is frozen by the curveball, strike three. So Edwin Jackson at least gets the first out of the inning, but he's got a lot of work to do. Next batter, Goldschmidt, strikes out on the curveball, swinging. Two outs. Can Edwin Jackson get out of this mess without anything happening to him? Yes, Trumbo strikes out. Three straight strikeouts to get out of the inning after allowing runners at second and third. Quite an escape job right there by Edwin Jackson. He made the mess, and he cleaned it up himself. Bottom of the third now. Let's see if the Cubs can break through. There's Ruggiano, who we featured before the game. He is grounding out right back to the pitcher. We go to the top of the fourth, still scoreless. This ball is tailing towards the left field line, and Lake dives but cannot get it. It'll be off the fence. He gets up quickly and gets the ball into the cutoff man, so it will be a double. Nice effort, but he's not able to get there in time. As you'll see the replay, this ball tailed away from Lake, and as he dove, he just could not get his glove on it. So that is a double, and once again, Edwin Jackson has to work with a runner in scoring position and nobody out. This is going to be strike three looking. Oh, wow. Hill does not like that. And he'll have to sit down. One out. This looks oddly familiar to the last inning. Chavez strikes out looking. Edwin Jackson, is he going to strike out the side yet again? Well, no. This one's actually hit out to left. This could score the first run of the ball game. Lake's throw is in time. They cut down the run at the plate. The Cubs escape once again without a run being scored. Cubs turn to try to break through now, going to the bottom of the fourth. Edwin Jackson wiping that sweat away, taking a deep breath because he gets out of there without a run against him. 3-2 count to Castro. He's going to walk as that one is high. Ball four, so he's on base with no one out. And this is Mike Olt. That is going to be knocked down by the shortstop. Play at first. No, everyone's safe. Could not get an out, even though they kept it in the infield. So here is Rizzo. Base hit to left. It's a sharp base hit, and everyone is going to stay right where they are. Base is loaded. And I believe nobody out after Rizzo singles. Can we get a run home? This is our best chance so far. 2-2 count. Scherholz is going to single. It gets down. The first run comes across the score for the Cubs. They're up 1-0. Finally, we push a run across, and it is Scherholz coming up with a hit. He continues to contribute more and more as we go on after a very cold start. This is a deep fly ball by Lake, and it should be an easy, well, yeah, they had a nice relay there. They get the sacrifice fly, and it's 2-0. So the Cubs doing the right things here, even when they get an out. Let's see if they can tack on even more. Darwin Barney is going to ground out into a fielder's choice, and that's the end of the inning. But the Cubs do strike for two. Let's see what Edwin Jackson can do with that. This is a fly ball to the left. Should be no problem for Junior Lake. He makes the catch. And the inning is over. There you go. Jackson's worked through five, giving up five hits and no runs against. Looking good. And let's see what the Cubs offense can do in the fifth inning. 3-2 count. And that's ball four to Ruggiano. Very patient right there. And he's going to draw a walk. Always love to have a base runner on for a hitter like Starlin Castro. He goes opposite field with this. It's carrying back, and it is gone into the right field bleachers. Two-run homer, Starlin Castro, and he doubles up the lead. 4-0 now. Hudson, obviously visibly upset at that pitch he threw Starlin Castro, but he cannot have it back. It was deposited into the bleachers for a two-run homer. 394 feet. And that is a great swing by Castro. Doubles the Cubs lead now from 2-4. Let's see if that is enough to get this game in the bag for the Cubs. This is the sixth inning now, and that's the second out for Edwin Jackson. And Trumbo is retired, but a little bit of trouble now. A runner on and a 3-1 count, and that is a base hit to center. We got to start being careful here because Edwin Jackson is nearing the 100 pitch count, and he's got a couple runners against. 104, actually, and trying to just let him get through the sixth, and he does it. Strikeout when he needs it. I believe he's got 10 or 11 of those at this point. As he finishes the sixth, he probably is done at 105 pitches. But he's pitched a shutout, and that was a great job getting through the sixth. He sucked it up and was able to do so. Darwin Barney with a runner on. This ball is to straightaway center and gone. Another two-run homer. The Cubs tack on some more insurance and make it 6-0 now. And the way that the pitching has gone so far, this could be a huge lead to try to cut back into. But we know what our bullpen's like. We've had issues. Let's see if we can get it right. First off, sending Wesley Wright out to work the seventh inning. Against all left-handed hitters, it made sense to bring a lefty in. He gets a strikeout right here of Gregorius. And next up, we got a 3-2 count and a ball hit right. And Rizzo steps on first, throw to second, double play the hard way. They get it. Still 6-0 as Wesley Wright does his job. And we go to the bottom of the seventh. The Cubs looking to tack on even more. They've had late inning meltdowns, specifically ninth inning meltdowns, and they don't want anything dramatic happening today. So Mike Olt gets a base hit up the middle. He will get on base, and maybe we can hit another two-run homer. That's kind of the path everything's been going the last few innings for the Cubs. So as Olt has another pretty decent day, upping that average, we have Rizzo at the plate again, and he is going to get a base hit. Oh, maybe not. That's a great play at second base. Wheels around and throws to the pitcher covering for the last out of the inning. So on to the eighth, and we bring in the former closer, Jose Veras, now in a setup role. Well, I know it's 6-0. It's not exactly a setup role today, but he is firing. He gets a couple strikeouts and gets through the eighth inning. Did walk a man, but he erases everyone else. And we are through the Diamondbacks half of the eighth. Cubs coming up in the bottom of the eighth now. And we've got Junior Lake at the plate again. That's a base hit. He had the sacrifice fly earlier. Now he's aboard with a hit. And we got runners at first and second. Nobody out. 3-2 count. And Baker is going to single his first hit of the game. And there we go. We got the bases loaded once again. One out now. And we've got the pinch hitter, Bonifacio, taking this to fairly deep center field. Should score a run. Our second sacrifice fly of the day makes it 7-0. And the Cubs look to be well on their way to victory today. Now the question is, will it be a shutout? We have Pedro Strop on the mound for the ninth, and he finishes it off. It is indeed a shutout. Edwin Jackson started it. The bullpen does their best to hold it down, and they combined as a unit do a great job today pitching, taking care of these Diamondbacks. Even when they were able to get on base, they did not allow them to score. Had a run cut down at the plate. Edwin Jackson is your player of the game. 11 strikeouts and one walk. He did a great job, especially when he got in jams. He bared down. He struck people out, and he got the outs he needed. So the Cubs take game one of the four-game series. We're going to go ahead and sim forward on the rest and get on out to Milwaukee. We win the second game, and then the games three and four go to the Diamondbacks. So it is a split going on to Milwaukee. And that is what will be up next. More Cubs baseball coming up. Thanks for joining me. See you later, guys. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the video, go ahead and join the SGU team. Like the SGU Facebook page. Follow us on Twitter. Go ahead and subscribe to SGU here on YouTube so you don't miss daily videos. And last but not least, follow us on Twitch for live streaming goodness.